name is Trudy Guffey, and I'm an instructor here at Gadsden State Community College. I teach psychology, I teach sociology, I do, well, nighttime classes, daytime classes, online classes. Used to be involved in teaching many different dual enrollment classes. Just want to welcome you to Gadsden State. I'm so excited to have a new set of students coming in for the fall, and so we really hope that you enjoy Gadsden State. It's my job to kind of just talk to you guys a little bit about what it's like as a college student, what you need to do, what are some few tips for you guys just to help you out just a little bit to be a successful college student. So most of our students at Gadsden State don't just take a full load of classes. You also have work commitments, you have family, right, that you're tending to. And so that's a lot on your plate. To be a full-time student at Gadsden State, that's 12 hours. And then if you're doing 12 hours and then at the same time you're working 25, 30 hours a week, and then you're trying to manage stuff at home, that can be a lot for our students. And so I just have just a few little tips for you, nothing big, just to maybe help you out just a little bit. So tip number one would be time management, all right? So it's really important, guys, to manage your time. So if you know you have 12 hours of schoolwork, well, I know this fall's gonna look a little different. Maybe you're not physically coming to campus for all 12 hours. Maybe you're taking a hybrid course where you're one day a week for each of your classes, and then the rest of the time you're working through our Blackboard system, right? Because the course is an online course. Or maybe it's fully online. You've got to set up that time just like you were in the seat, right? In the classroom, you need to set up that time at home, okay? So let's say on Mondays, you don't have to go into work till 2 o'clock. Well, you know, be a good boy and girl and get on up at 8 o'clock and have an 8 o'clock class, you know? And even though it's online, you let your, class be an 8 a.m. online class or something. But go ahead and set that up through the week. Then you know your work schedule, so go ahead and kind of lay that out for yourself. And then, yes, you need that time with your family. They need you, you need them. So make sure that you provide that time. But then don't forget, just because I'm attending that online class at 8 a.m. doesn't mean I'm not supposed to study for that class sometime later in the day. Okay, so part of time management is just thinking, what do I need to get done today? How am I going to best utilize my time today? So I would recommend that you think like that and write it out. It just helps. I know that's weird. Y'all don't write anything out anymore. I'm a writer outer on a piece of paper. Just write it out. It'll just make your life so much easier. And just check it off. It'll also make you feel good just to draw a line through it or put a check mark by it, or something like that. But I also would say don't schedule every moment of your time, because that's not really effective time management skills. So leave time open, because things always happen, right? Okay, so then I would say stay ahead of your assignments when you're taking your classes, especially since most of our stuff this fall is going to be online. Guys, you really need to stay ahead of those due dates, okay? Now, the way I view a due date is that it is the last day something is due. It's not the day you do it, it's the last day it's due, right? So when you go to turn something in, turn it in advance, okay? Don't be thinking, oh, it's due today, let me do it today. No. Get your work done ahead of time if you can. It really will help you to stay ahead in your classes and to not feel so overwhelmed, okay? And so that kind of leads me into the next little tip, which is stress management, okay? So all of us have to deal with stress, and especially in our day and time. Oh my goodness, our world is dealing with a lot, guys, right? We love each other. We want everybody to be healthy and happy, but right now we're just having little battles, right? So we want to be able to manage our stress. And so one very effective way, says the research, to manage stress is through exercise. Now, I'm preaching to the choir here, okay? So I know that we don't love exercise, not all of us, but you need to do some form of exercise, okay? It will actually make you physically feel better, which helps you emotionally feel better, which is going to mean that you're gonna be a better coworker, you're gonna be a better member of your family, and you're gonna do better in school. So think about coming up with something, even if you just walk 3 times a week or something, just do something. And then there are other fun ways you can manage your stress. I love to watch romantic comedies, that's my thing. So whatever it is that you enjoy, somebody said TikTok, and I know that's like all my daughter's thing, right? They love some TikTok, But even TikTok tells you that you're not supposed to be staring at and scrolling through TikTok 24/7, right? That little guy comes on there and he says, okay, I know you love TikTok, but take a break, right? Go sleep, go get you something to eat, is something else, right? So whatever it is that you do that's fun, video games, I know people love to do those now, whatever it is, okay? Just participate in some things that are fun, because it'll actually help to relieve that stress from you and get you energized to get back to work, to get back to your classes, to be successful, and that's what we want. And the other last tip I would say is get a good night's rest. The overwhelming majority of us do not sleep, and when I ask my students in our psychology class about their sleep patterns, I find that probably out of a class of 25, maybe 3 or 4 don't have some form of insomnia. Now, that is crazy for me to say, and that's not, you know, statistically, you know, accurate. That's just me asking my classes, but it's usually about 3 or 4 who do not have some kind of insomnia. The rest of us, we're all sleep deprived, okay? So we need to get a good night's rest. So I encourage you to get you a good night's rest, put that phone away, but also enjoy some downtime, do some time management, make sure to complete your assignments ahead of time. And so that these are just some basic little tips to help you to be successful for this fall semester. Look, we're pumped, we're excited. We can't wait to talk with you through our online classes, maybe get to see some of you face-to-face if we're fortunate enough to get to do that. Our doors and our faculty are very accessible to students. We want students to be successful. We want you to be the best that you can be. Our job is to help you to be successful so that you can complete that degree, so that you can pursue whatever that opportunity is for you. And we want to be a part of that. So contact us. You know, I know my email information is out for you guys. It's tguffy@gadsdenstate.edu. There's many others here on campus you can contact. But we're thankful that you chose Gadsden State. Welcome to Gadsden State.